we're beginning to reopen our state, in our businesses and the churches. Please keep praying for those that are still struggling and for those in authority over us, that they might listen to the voice of God for the benefit of the people in our country. Please keep praying for those that are infected by this virus. And let's keep looking to Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Let's pray. Oh, Father God, we come to give you praise this morning. Accept our gift of worship and gratitude, and thank you that we can be together even though we are apart. We pray all these things in the precious name of Jesus our Lord. Amen.
The cross is empty. The tomb is empty. Hallelujah. Jesus is the reason to be joyful, even in the midst of trouble. Let us worship and sing. Christ is alive.
The scripture reading this morning comes to us from the book of Psalm. There will be three different passages. Psalm 36, 1 through 4, Psalm 37, 1 through 4, and Psalm 19, verse 14. These passages speak to us of those who have deceit in their hearts because they do not love God. And it's also a plea to God to help us keep our focus on God so that we do not fall into that same type of deception. Here's a reading from Psalm 36. Have a message from God in my heart concerning the sinfulness of the wicked. There is no fear of God before their eyes. In their own eyes, they flatter themselves too much to detect or hate their sin. The words of their mouths are wicked and deceitful. They fail to act wisely or do good. Even on their beds, they plot evil. They commit themselves to a sinful course and do not reject what is wrong. Now this reading from Psalm 37. Do not fret because of those who are evil or be envious of those who do wrong. For like the grass, they will soon wither like green plants. they will soon die away. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and enjoy safe pasture. Take delight in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. So now turning back to Psalm 19, verse 14. This is a favorite scripture for many people. May these words of my mouth and this meditation of my heart be pleasing in your sight, my Lord, my rock, and my Redeemer. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Now, why would they do that? They saw that Jesus was kind He was caring, he was loving, he cared for the people, and he honored God. Well, it's because Jesus was going against the status quo and upsetting a good thing they had going. They said that Jesus' message was too revolutionary. They said his impact was too dangerous, and too many people were following Jesus. So they concluded that the law of Moses gave them no power to put anyone to death like the Romans did, and that is what they wanted for Jesus. But this would require an act of cunning and deception. They would look for ways to try to bait Jesus by deceit so that the Romans and the people would turn against Jesus. They planned to trap him into saying things that they could use against him. They tried to distract him so he wouldn't accomplish his God-given purpose. But it didn't work. Not until God said it was time for Jesus to do what he came to earth for, and that was to die for a sinful, rebellion world of people made in God's image. And there was another reason why they couldn't get Jesus off track, and this is something that you and I as believers need to pay attention to. Jesus was prayed up. He made a point to be with God the Father every morning, noon, and night. He read the scriptures every chance he could get. He called on God in every turn, and God empowered him with his Holy Spirit. Listen, even today, evil people who hate God still seek to destroy the followers of Jesus Christ. We see that happening all over the world and even in our own country. They resort to all kinds of dishonesty to confuse and discourage. They want us to be engaged in side issues and sucked into the culture and get stuck in their ideologies. They want to weaken the unity of the body of Christ, to weaken our faith and ridicule our commitment to the kingdom of God. Their goal is for us to abandon the work of evangelism and discipleship. Just in Jesus' day, their agenda is the same, to put to death the gospel of Jesus Christ. In Matthew 7, Jesus warned us with these words, "Not everyone says, 'Lord, Lord,' is of you." Absolutely. And many have been swayed down through the ages, and it happens when you and I are not prayed up and in the Word daily. It happens when people care more about what society says than what God says. It happens when we desire power and attention, or let fear instead of faith have its way. And when that happens, we open ourselves up to all the deception that Satan wants to throw at us. Didn't Satan say to Eve way back in the book of Genesis? Now, God didn't really say you couldn't eat off the tree of good and evil, did he? Surely, God knows if you do, you'll be like him. Well, Adam and Eve fell for that, and we've been falling for that lie ever since. Right now in our world, all across our world, fear instead of faith is a driving force of the deception in our world. Evangelist Greg Laurie said this, and I'm going to quote him. "Sometimes it can be really hard to step away from our fears and turn toward God. But we must do so every day, especially during this season of uncertainty like the one we are living in right now. Things can seem impossible. But remember, we are children of God. are already victorious through Christ. We must never forget that. You know, Jesus and his disciples were up against the same deception in the day in which they live as we are right now, because the heart of humanity and sin have not changed one bit. You see, before Jesus was crucified, he said something shocking, and it's still shocking to some of us today. He said this: "Do you suppose that I have come to bring peace to the earth? I did not come to bring peace, but a sword." A sword? Well, didn't the angels sing about peace on earth when Jesus was born? And didn't Jesus at his resurrection say to his disciples, "Peace be to you"? And doesn't the Bible say that Christ is our peace? But we read these words in Hebrews chapter 4. "For the word of God is living and active, and we know the word of God is Jesus himself. And he is sharper than any double-edged sword. It penetrates even its dividing soul and spirit, joint and marrow. It judges the thoughts and the hearts of humankind." The word of God will divide the thoughts of people. The word will divide the truth from a lie, good from evil. God will separate the real Christians from those opposing him. Jesus warned his disciples back in Matthew 10 to avoid all things which give advantage to the enemy. Our enemies are those that oppose Christ. The Bible tells us, Jesus said it himself, we are to be wise as serpents, but yet gentle as doves. He said avoid the meddling with worldly and political concerns. Now, that doesn't mean that we shouldn't know what's going on. We are to obey our government, but we are to be aware and exercise our right to vote and all the other rights that we have in the nations in which we live, but not to be caught up in the quagmire of it all. Because no matter what people will try to do, God is in control, mere men. God's plan and purpose for us is not to harm us, but to give us a future with a hope. Oh, if only we had as much zeal for the Lord Jesus Christ as we do for our political parties and those things that we attach ourselves to in this world. So you might say, well, how do I know if I'm being deceived? The Lord Jesus didn't leave us without information and direction. In John 16, 13, he says this: "When the Spirit of truth comes, and he has to all believers, he will guide us into all truth. For he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears from God, he will speak to us. And he will declare to us the things that are to come." We don't have to wonder. We don't have to guess. The Bible tells us in trouble, you and I are to stand strong and confirm our faith and to listen for the voice of the Holy Spirit speaking to our hearts. We need to know if we are redeemed people, followers of Jesus, we're going to face deception just like Jesus and his disciples did in their time. Christians are not immune, but we've been told to watch out, because we've been told that we live in the midst of deception, in the midst of deceitful people who will not and refuse to acknowledge God. Just as they did to Jesus, people who hate God will try to bait you and try to distract you with their rhetoric and their humanistic ideology. But God has not left us to figure this out on our own. In Ephesians 5, he tells us this: "Let no one deceive you with their empty words, for because of such things, God's wrath will come on those who are disobedient. Therefore, do not be partners with the wicked." In 1 Peter 2:1, Peter said, "Rid yourself of of all malice and all deceit and all hypocrisy and envy and slander. And if they're in your heart, let them go and ask God to forgive you. If we don't want to follow that pattern of distortion and call evil good and good evil as we see in our world, we need to get on our knees and we need to get in the Word of God. We don't have to despair. We already have power in the name of Jesus. Pray, pray, pray in the powerful name of Jesus. And Jesus said this to us. He said, I've told you these things, so when the time comes, you will remember that I warned you against the evil ones. God's word tells us to test the spirits, because there are good and evil spirits in this world. And yes, there are false Christians, and there are deceitful people who disguise themselves as followers of Christ. That should not surprise us, because Jesus warned us that even Satan disguises himself as an angel of light. So here is how we keep from being deceived. In 2 Corinthians 2:13, it tells us this: examine yourselves to test to see whether you are in the faith. Ask yourself, what kind of spirit grabs a hold of me? You know, from time to time, we're just human, even if we're saved. That human nature comes bubbling up and people go against us. Could you have the spirit of selfishness or prejudice or criticism grabbing a hold of you? Maybe you're one of those people who envies and you get jealous. Or maybe you're one of those people who passes on false information and gossip and you cause division, even if you don't want to. Maybe, like so many right now, you have that spirit of fear. Friends, God's word says that God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and love and a sound mind. We don't have to run around like people without hope, because God has said he's never going to leave us or forsake us. If you are a believer, Christ Jesus is in you. I think one of the problems we have today is there are so many voices in our world today. If the voices you listen to day after day, whether it's media or your family or your neighbors, spew hatred and fear and division, or they disavow God and his people, you will be deceived. You must be responsible for what goes into your own mind, because a steady diet of negativity can cause even the most steadfast to falter. Ask God to help you sift out those voices. But let me tell you, friends, it's up to you and me to balance those voices with the voices of God. And I can tell you, it's only going to come from his word and time spent on your knees in prayer. That sounds like a broken record, but that is what we're supposed to do. Pray and read the word of God. Paul warned us in 1 Thessalonians 5:21 to test everything, absolutely everything, and never to hold on to what is bad, but hold on to what is good. In Ephesians 15, we have this warning: be very careful then how you live, not as unwise, but wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is for your life. We are from God. Whoever knows God listens to God. Whoever's not from God does not listen to God. And it shows. By this we know the spirit of truth and the spirit of lies. God will help us give the discernment to separate falsehoods from the truth. Listen, friends, one of these days Jesus is coming back, just as he said. But until then, allow Jesus to equip you to be strong and courageous, to be faithful and true to his word, Remember, we're people of hope, and God has given us every single tool we need to walk by faith. Ask God to help you be aware of the deception in the world. Ask Him how to show you if you've been deceived in any way with your thinking. Don't give in, and don't give up. Trust in Jesus. Fill your mind with His Word and learn to be sensitive to the Holy Spirit. Let's ask the Lord Jesus for guidance. Let's pray. Oh, loving Father, thank You that You're not a God of confusion, but a God of love and mercy. We know that we're living in a time of so much deception that it's often difficult to know what is the truth. But You have told us that if we know the truth will set us free, and Jesus is the truth. Thank You, Lord, that You have already set believers free from the bondage of sin and death. Open our eyes to those who are not yet firmly planted in your name, Lord Jesus. Touch the hearts of those who do not believe. Grant us discernment and understanding heart to be able to identify and reject what is false and deceptive. Help us to test every spirit and give us wisdom to know the difference. We pray in the powerful name of Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Our desire is to grow more like Jesus each day. In that way, we are made aware of those things Jesus warned us about. We want Him to fill our hearts with His desire so that we might be more like Him.
Go in peace. Amen.